Ransomware has gotten a lot smarter. It doesn't just attack production environments anymore. It's targeting your backup system on the same network. That's why we need an air-gapped copy of your backup data, stored on a server that's completely isolated from your main network. This keeps your backups safely out of attackers' reach. ActiveProtect takes this concept a step further with an automated air gap. It's designed to automatically open the connection only when it's time to create a backup copy. Once the task is complete, it immediately disconnects and restores the isolated state. This means you no longer have to unplug cables or deactivate network cards. It's all automatic, which reduces the risk of error and the burden on your IT team. ActiveProtect achieves this automated air gap through its dual port network design. The management port connects to a secure, isolated network for administration, while the data port connects to your production environment to handle backup and restore traffic. The air gap works by automatically switching the data port between two modes. In access mode, data transfers normally. In block mode, the port shuts off to create a complete network gap. Meanwhile, the management port remains active, so you can still perform maintenance or restoration drills even when the system is isolated. This design provides flexibility. Using a simple time grid, you can schedule specific backup windows for data transfer. For example, schedule access mode from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. for backup copying. Outside this window, your backup copy remains offline and secure. ActiveProtect provides even deeper control than just a schedule. You can fine-tune security for both access and block modes to match your needs. A highly secure setup is to allow only essential transfers in access mode, and then have the system deactivate the network card during block mode. Here's how this works in practice. Say you've scheduled access mode from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. The data port opens, and backups from an allowed IP address begin to transfer. But what happens if the transfer finishes early, lead to exposure window? To close this, the system shuts off the network card and restores isolation when ActiveProtect tracks that the data transfer is complete, keeping your environment fully protected. Even with the data port's network card turned off, the system is still fully manageable. The dedicated management port remains active, so your team can perform maintenance or run restoration drills while the backup data stays completely secure. In this video, we will demonstrate how to configure the air gap in ActiveProtect Manager and show you how to perform a restoration drill for an offsite backup. You can find the timestamps for each section in the video description. First, we'll demonstrate how to configure an air gap. Air gaps work on any ActiveProtect appliance, but we recommend applying them to a backup copy server. Even if your main systems or primary backups are compromised, these copies remain isolated, ensuring your business continuity. For this demo, our protection plan is already set to use a server named Backup Copy Site. To configure it, let's go to Infrastructure, Backup Servers, select Backup Copy Site, and then switch to the Air Gap tab. Here you'll set up two options, Access Mode and Access Period. Access Mode defines how the system is connected and isolated, while Access Period determines when these actions occur on a schedule. Let's start with Access Mode. The system provides two presets for common use cases. Basic Mode is straightforward. Connections are allowed during the access window, and all inbound traffic is blocked during isolation, giving a basic level of network protection. Hardened Mode offers a higher level of security. During the allow window, the data port is enabled only when a backup copy is actively being transferred and shuts down immediately after. During the block window, it stays off entirely, limiting exposure and reducing the risk of attacks. For more requirements, you can select Customize Access Settings to fine-tune the rules. With the mode selected, the next step is to configure the access period, which is the schedule for connecting and isolating the appliance. To ensure the appliance has enough time to complete its tasks before isolating again, you can calculate the required time using this formula. The change rate here indicates how much data changes each day, while the deduplication rate shows the space saved by skipping redundant data. For example, a company has 10 servers, each with 2 terabytes of data, and a typical daily change rate of about 10%. factoring in a common deduplication rate of 50%, the actual amount of data to be copied might be around 1 terabyte. Based on this estimate and our network speed, we can determine how long the access window should be. For this demo, we'll use 5 hours and set the schedule in the table below, where gray cells show the block window. Now save the settings, and the system will manage the connection automatically. This creates a persistent, precise isolation barrier for your backup copies, reducing the chance of ransomware attacks. The air gap is now active on our backup copy server, which is currently in its scheduled isolation. As you can see on the connectivity tab, the data port is offline. Unlike traditional offline backups, ActiveProtect keeps the appliance fully manageable during isolation, so you can still perform restoration drills to ensure your backups are reliable. Let's demonstrate a restore from the backup copy using a virtual machine. Our VM data has been successfully backed up and copied off-site. To test the restore, select the VM. Open the recovery portal. Choose a backup version and click Restore to Virtual Machine. Make sure to select the data stored on our backup copy server called Backup Copy Site. Since this is a test, we'll use Restore to built-in hypervisor for a fast VM boot to check its status. We can leave all VM settings at default and start the restore process. By clicking View, you can track the progress. When the status says Ready to Migrate, the VM has booted from the backup, and you can connect to verify it's working. These restoration drills let you regularly confirm that your isolated off-site copies are fully functional without impacting your production environment. To learn more about how ActiveProtect secures your data, be sure to check out our other videos,